Hey, Chris Menard here. We're going to take a look at Copilot in Microsoft Excel. I'm only looking at one specific item, but I'm going to do at least three examples, and that is using Copilot to create conditional formatting on my data. I'll look at text, I'll look at dates, and I'll look at numbers. Let's take a look at this exercise right now. I'm in my data. I've already met the three requirements to use Copilot in Excel. It is saved to OneDrive or SharePoint. Autosave is turned on or enabled. And finally, it is already set up as a table. I did that by clicking in my data and doing Control T. That is why I have table design. Quick tip for you. If you see Autosave on, you know it's saved to OneDrive or SharePoint. You cannot turn Autosave on if you're saving to some shared drive at your work. It's got to be OneDrive or SharePoint. Let's take a look at the Copilot features. Go to Home. Here is Copilot. We're only worried about the conditional formatting on this exercise. So I'm just going to come down here and click, and I'm going to start off with something that's text, and I'm going to use state, which is in column E. My prompt was for the state field, make GA appear in a green background color. What is interesting is about that is that's technically called a fill color, but Copilot was able to pick it up. It came back and said done. I'm not going to sit there and read all of that for you. If I did not like it, I would hit undo right here. But that is actually perfect. In case you're wondering what happened, I'm going to select E2 down. This is not required. I'm just showing you what it did. If I come on the Home tab to Conditional Formatting and go select Manage Rules, it wrote a rule that for this table, it is going to take GA and put it in that color. That was pretty cool. And especially, that's really cool, especially if you have no clue how to use conditional formatting. Let's do another one. This time, let's pick on those purchases to date, which are numbers. Perfect. My prompt was for the purchases to date, make any number over 1,000 in a yellow background color. Take a look at column H. I will scroll up. Copilot is saying done, and it's telling me exactly what it did. And again, just to prove it, not required. If I go to conditional formatting, manage rules, I should now have two rules, any cell values over 1,000. What is cool about this, as I just mentioned, if you have no clue how to use conditional formatting, this is a great feature because I'm just typing in what I would say, basically. Also, I'm in cell H2. It's got the number 893. Let's make it 1200 and press Enter, and the conditional formatting takes over. I will do a Control Z there to undo and put it back to 893. Last one for conditional formatting, I'm going to take a look at these invoice dates. You don't have to be in that column, so let me just click over somewhere else. And for Copilot, I have done dates, we've done numbers and text, and we used a background color. I mixed it up this time with the invoice dates. Make any invoice date after July 5th, 2023 in a red font color, and it actually came back and did that. Just to test it one more time, here is 630. Let's make this 7-6-2023, and it goes that color. I will do an undo with the mouse. And just to check this one, let's go look at our rules here. By the way, I did not have to select those invoice dates. I know I just did. They're the three rules that Copilot wrote for us using conditional formatting. This is pretty cool. It did the date value. Interesting. But it's correct. I hope you enjoyed this video. My Microsoft Excel online training class is available. Have a great day. Thank you.